Ahmedabad Track is known as Path to Dreams. It treats you with amazing scenery of Himalayas throughout the 5 days of trek. Varying from lush greenery to contrasting exposure of deserted mountains. Located in the Pir Panjal range of Himalayas, Ahmedabad is like a beautiful canvas with all your favorite colors in it. According to one legend, Ahmedabad got its name after a rishi, Ahmeda Maharishi, who meditated here. This route is also known as Staircase to Heaven. According to Indian mythology of Mahabharata, this trek was travelled by the Pandavas in the quest for heaven. It begins from Manali. The drive from Manali takes 2 hours to reach Jobra, and from Jobra, trek starts. First day is just 2 kilometers of trek, not a tiring one. It's like a warm up for the upcoming challenges on day 2 and day 3.
Be still, my darling.
It's an easy trek to the Chika campsite on the bank of Rani Nala. As you are away from civilization, it is suggested you to take a technology detox and keep your mobile aside. But snapping pictures and selfie is fine.
Oh, darling, don't be scared.
So, you guys take the water bottle, back lunch, clear, and make sure your tent gonna be checked double. There is nothing to left. Because sometimes there gonna be like a next group coming over here, so they're gonna be occupied the tent. So, it's gonna be like a misplaced sometimes something. So, make sure your tent gonna be like empty, especially your sleeping bag thing.
It's a picture perfect view, starts from the beginning of the day. Begins from Chika and takes you to grassland and rocky path. Best part of day 2 is to cross those fast flowing river streams coming straight from the deep glacier inside the Himalayas. Ahmedabad Track is doable in the 3 months window, June, July and August. Before and after these months, the track route is completely closed as the place receives heavy snowfall.
Go, go. Go.
It's up to the trekker's choice. This place is magical and you won't regret even a minute after coming here. day 2 ends at Palukagera campsite. We did 9 kilometers of trekking on day 2 and was a bit tired but satisfied. This campsite is situated in between the valley, and campsite was set just along the river. Day 3 is a fitness challenge. Fitness is an important factor when it comes to trekking, because this day we will face the serious incline in the entire trek. Final ascent to Humta Pass.
Darling, I know it's hard to let go. Soon I will hold you again. Longer days when I'm away, but we'll both pretend to be bold.
It is an high altitude trek at an elevation of
धन्यवाद अंकल जी।
After a serious incline, we are at Humta Pass. At the topmost point, it seems like Himalayas have opened up here, deepest secret for the trekkers to peek into. The pass term actually means the route connecting one valley with the other.
Humta Pass.
At the pass, stay and relax for a while, but do not take long. Leave the place and descend. We don't recommend stays at high points because weather changes are usual and our safety is important. The descent is quite difficult. After crossing the pass, it's a different valley, Lahore and Spiti Valley. Spiti Valley is quite popular for its huge mountains all around. The reason Spiti Valley is famous and different from other valleys is its desert mountains. After a challenging descent, we reach Shia Guru, In local dialect, Shiyaguru itself means the coldest place. So keep yourself warm. Day 4. Trek is started little early for the day because after reaching our campsite, which is not more than 2 to 3 hours from Shiyaguru, it is simple descent to Chatru campsite, last campsite near the road connecting Manali Khasa Highway. This trail is just a piece of cake for us, as we crossed tougher ones earlier while crossing the pass. We will utilize the opportunity of sightseeing and take the sightseeing road trip to Lahaul Spiti Road. So, the last treat for our eyes and soul is this Chandratal Lake, nested between the softy peaks of the Pirpanjal at the height of 4,250.